third or no, that's just A.
Go to your third fret, I believe.
Right, for D.
No, this is F.
Yeah,
oh, yeah. Yeah. When I play it in D chord.
Play in D chord.
Recording it yet.
Okay, I know that.
Yeah, yeah, but Old St. Joe will be okay.
That sounds good. Yeah.
Yeah. No, we haven't had, nobody's done it yet.
Nobody.
Well, let's just let you record all these for us if you don't mind. It sounds great.
Okay.
And when you get ready to play, announce your tune then.
Okay, are we ready? Are we going to?
Well, we're rolling. What's it? And where'd you get it from, too?
Okay, this is the Fruit Jar Rag, and I learned it from my Uncle Jesse Silvey. Where he learned it, I don't know.
I made you nervous, and Gordon was coughing there. So.
All right.
I was trying to hold it.
That's fine with me.
Get out your cough.
Okay. Well, it's down in here, see. It's hard to do. There, I probably got it. No, it's down. It's the same thing Bob Holt has. That stuff's okay.
Boy, that is a great tune. Man. Okay.
Okay, do I need to announce it again?
No. Take two.
No, I don't need it. It's fine. Go ahead.
St. Joe.
Okay. Thank you.
On the first part, there's no BADs or anything in that.
So. Okay, what, Bennett's reel?
Bennett's reel.
So much better that time over the last time. I about got it. I mean, it just little slight rough spots.
Yeah, I That's a lot of work.
That's a lot of work.
A lot of fiddling in that tune.
Yeah, that's why I started. I was listening there and I was thinking that.
It sounds quite good, but.
I know several places that I made the wrong finger movements.
Take two.
I failed to go twice around there. On
fine,
the...
fine. Just, it's okay. Here we go. Well.
All right, Gordon. Let's try it again.
Turn that up. Okay.
Okay. Start again.
Thank you.
you use it, you'll have to cut the end off of it because I blew it right smack on it.
We'll just do another end. Keep the same.
Go through it one more time. Yeah, just one more time. Say. Yeah. One more time. Just go through it once.
And end it.
some
metal. Think it's Metallica Free or Blackhawk. Bob was always arguing with him.
Okay.
Go ahead, and if you're up to
all right, let's see if I can. It'll be kind of rough, but these tunes that like that, and see, I don't know when I played that last.
I started to say that to me, they're always close.
Yeah, is that okay. The way it goes?
I think, yeah.
Let me get rid of this. Now, if I can think of the bridge part of it.
Change there in the...
Okay. Thank you. Does that sound like the spotted pony that you know?
Yeah. We play it so close to Waldo, I get the two confused. But no, that sounds like it.
Well, Sam's...
I tell you, the only people... Get... Only...
Wonder if it came... Do you know when he brought it down there? When did you hear him play it? Long time ago?
First time I ever heard it was long about...
Uh-huh. I bet you must have got it from the old Doc Roberts record.
Right.
Well, he's just a, he was kind of a farmer, and then he did blacksmith of on Saturdays down at OC, and left-handed. And he whistled all the time he was working down there. You could hear that old anvil ringing. And that's where I got to learn him.
And did he play the fiddle too?
Yeah, he was a good fiddler.
What was his name again?
Alan Jennings. Jennings. Uh-huh. But he left here and went to California. And he got to be, they brought tape over here. He was 90-some years old when he died.
You have a tape of him playing?
No, I don't. Old, what you call him, he brought me one, and he just played it and took it back with him. Mm-hmm. Old Wallace Jennings. That was his uncle. He was brought up here one night when we hear him. He was pretty old then, you know. Yeah. And that Sadie, that was his tune, too.
That was written by Bob Holtman, saying he was about his favorite of the ones you play too.
So was it?
Yeah, why don't you do that,
Silvey? All right. Smile. He's your own.
Yeah, I got you. I'm doing this for the police, Melvin.
Yeah.
Up there, Campbell. You remember him? Galloway had played there?
No.
He was a preacher. Boy, he was the best I ever heard of him.
Art played it, I don't know.
Did he? Thank you. no good on that.
That's pretty. Play a little bit just all by yourself so I can hear that, the melody.
Oh, I'll try it then. I got a little on last. I never could play that blue mute.
Did you know him?
Or well, I know some records of him.
Yeah.
I never did see him.
Uh-huh.
But we went out there and played with, not far from him, but we never saw him. We played with that. Yeah, we went up to Grove, too, in Jay, Oklahoma, and oh, that man named it, Johnny Masters.
Yeah.
Went up and played with him, son. You ever hear of him?
I've heard about him. I don't think I've ever heard of him.
Only thing I ever heard him play was Texas stuff.
He played just...
I've just heard him a couple of times in Tahlequah.
Yeah, he may be on Texas stuff now.
Well,
I don't know.
It was who he was playing with at that time. I never did, but everybody said he learned under Uncle Dick Hutchison.
Yeah. He said also he'd go to them our fiddle contest, and he never could win one as long as Uncle Dick lived.
Yeah.
He never could win one.
I once talked to Hutchison on the telephone.
You did?
Yeah. Well, once upon a time, I wanted to have that record company put out his record, and he agreed to do it, but the record company never followed through. And those are great records.
Yeah, my brother had half a dozen of them records. Oh,
I had both of them. I lost one of them.
And I learned nothing off him was that played the sharecropper. I've always been Melvin's favorite out there.
Right,
that's a sharecropper. Now, let's see if we can think of that Delaware or Polly put the kettle on or whatever it is. Yeah.
Thank you.
I believe that was better one, don't you?
Yeah, yeah.
A D?
Yeah, I don't have got those records.
Well, good. Yeah.
Well, I got a tape. Lead old ball to water.
Leading old ball to water.
And you got that from the skillet records? Or where'd you get
that? Yeah, that's where it comes from. I've got that other skillet liquor too. Is that I played it a while ago. Old Liberty.
Right, you played that for me last time.
Yeah. Did you get in?
Yeah, why don't we do that again? Let's do old ball.
I've turned out with that old ball.
Talking about
that ball up there. That ain't it. Did you call Jesse James?
You call that Jesse James?
That's yeah. Old Seneca Queen War dance.
Seneca, yeah, they call it that, Seneca Square Dance?
Yeah, Square yeah. Dance.
Is that
yeah.
What you call that?
No, I didn't call it nothing. I was just going to him.
That's
the
name of it. Okay, do that one first. All righty. Seneca Square Dance.
Why'd you tell me the name of it? You called Jesse James.
I don't come anymore. I can't think.
Right over here on the mountain. Yeah. I've known him all my life. But I heard he was getting in bad health.
Well,
somebody went out there and he wouldn't play.
Sugar diabetes left to got him.
Was that what it was?
Yeah, he got out and got on.
I know he got just playing a fiddle festival out there.
Yeah, he's playing all of them now. Lose with
all he's one of them long
sunny,
in
sunny
the fiddle.
Yeah,
Sunnyside, Washington.
You have his address?
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Thank you. never noticed him. Before the war, back 40s, I guess. When I was out there, I wasn't married or nothing. Just, man, I rode a freight train back, and I had a page in silver dollars out there. And what I had was in one pocket, and it is kind of hard to hold your britches up. I stayed out there. Oh, about a little before Christmas, and I just wanted to come home. It's 40 below when I got on that old train. And I was supposed to have been watching over a carload of sheep. But I got on that train, they just snow and beat 60. And I never did see them sheep anymore. I guess they made it through. But, only time I'd have to change cabooses once in a while, they'd put it on another train, you know, them sheep. Come, it didn't cost me a thing. I come plumb to St. Joe. And then I had to buy me a ticket from there on down here. Yep. But I had a good time playing them days. We go plumb out across them bad lines, and he had an old 36 Chevy, new one. And, we'd go to Montana, maybe. Wasn't no house across there, just road. Just a one-lane road, too, most of the time. Yeah.
What was his name?
Cox.
Yeah.
His name was Cox. I never did forget that. And his boy, he had a boy. They mostly had a piano in every one of them schoolhouses. And he was good on that piano. But I left there that cold night, and I never did hear of them again. I liked him.
Did you pick up any fiddle tunes from him?
No. They played funny tunes there. But he'd start playing, about the time you got started, he'd stop. And then the crowd, they'd just cheer him, and he'd cut loose again. There's little tunes that they'd mount and I'd get out and get under the moon, such as that, you know. I never seen nothing like that. And at about time you think you got started, he'd stop. And they'd clap their hand and at it they'd go again, you know. Up towards Yellowstone Park, we played up in there. Got that. That's an old tune. record out of that.
Well, yeah, Straw Breakdown.
Yeah, Straw, I see.
Yeah, I played that sometime around. Style?
Yeah, how'd you learn? I was talking to Bob Holt about it, about the way you roll the bow there. Did you invent that yourself?
Well, yes, I don't remember ever learning from anybody. That's that okay?
Well, that way your bow, the kind of long bow, I don't know.
I don't know.
That idea of that bowing.
I don't know where that comes from. I guess I waddled into it.
That's
right?
One of your own.
I guess it is.
To play a little solo. So I want to hear so I can see if I can ever learn that myself.
You don't same to you?
Yeah, settle okay.
Not talking about him or nothing.
I never did.